Hello, good evening. Hello, Alexandra. Cristina, good evening. We just wait a few seconds to start, but today is one of the least, the smaller group we ever had in these classes up to now. Hello, Elena. Looks like it can rain any moment now. Just take a few moments just to be here. Like if nothing has to happen even 1 second from now. Just notice your body. Notice that you're breathing. Give yourself a few seconds just to notice that you're breathing. You know, we feel so much that we have to do things, to move, to accomplish, to get to the next moment. And we feel that way. One reason why we feel that way, because the whole world feels that way. Feels that way. Everybody feels that they are going somewhere. And the few moments when we are able to stop is because we are enjoying ourselves with some drinks or some unimportant talking. I'm thinking this because they just opened a new bar in the front of, in the corner of my house, which is very nice. But you can see people there are more relaxed. But they're relaxed, they have the glass of wine or the glass of beer, and they feel relaxed, but it's like there is not alertness. There is relaxation, which is very good, but there is not alertness in that relaxation. And when I mean to stop, I don't mean the relaxation that implies a glass of wine or the relaxation that implies watching a movie. These are very good if you want to do them. There is nothing wrong with them. but it's not the kind of stopping that I'm talking about. It's very different. The kind of stopping that I talk about is a stopping of a relaxation, but also an alertness of what is, an alertness of what is inside, an alertness of what is outside. You know, today I was reading the news, and there was an advertising or some kind of news that was saying, here are the best Netflix shows that you can see to fill up every moment of your free time. That was the title. Here are the best Netflix shows for you to fill up every moment of your free time. And there's nothing wrong with enjoying Netflix, of course not. But this idea, which it's amazing that they use it for the title, this idea of filling up every moment of your free time. No, that's not what it is about. It's fine to enjoy your moment. It's fine to do something nice in a moment, but don't fill up your moment. Live your moment. Every moment is our life. Never just fill up a moment. Never do that. Try to avoid with as much as you can. Avoid filling up your moment. Experience your moment, live your moment. Even if it's something very simple, like watching a movie, that's okay. But don't have this feeling of filling up a moment. And even more than that, don't fill up your moments with activities, with things, with entertainment. But once in a while, when you have this free time, come back, connect, experience, be in the moment. Don't fill up that free moment with something to do. Sometimes we do, but don't do it as a default. Don't just fill up your free moments as a default. Sometimes you do, but sometimes don't fill up those moments. Feel this openness that appears when we have a free moment. Actually, I did a meditation last Sunday about this great openness. Allow this openness to appear in your life. This openness is always there. Often we fill up with activities, and that's okay. But don't make it like a default that every time you have a free moment, you want to cover up. Because that's in itself, that's suffering. Even if it doesn't look like, in the moment, it is suffering. And so in the class, although we do a lot of activities, we do a lot of movement, we do a lot of things, try not to let the gym, the movements, fill up your moment. Keep this space in you. Keep this openness in you, even as you do the gym, which means don't get lost in the gym. Do the gym, but keep this sense of presence, this sense of awareness, this sense of I am here. And in this presence, this openness is very clear. Because this openness is all the time. There is only this openness, which apparently is covered by our activities. Recognize this openness. Don't keep covering it. Be part of it. Connect to it, see it, and recognize that that big openness you are. Anyway, that's another subject. Let's go to do some of the gym. I'm still injured. I cannot do some of the movements. I can do more, but still I'm not completely fine. So I will do what I will do my best, but also for you, same thing. Just do what you can and what you cannot do. Just accommodate your possibilities. I will be doing that myself. Okay, let's go to the mat. If you want to sit in a comfortable position, just cross your legs. Push your glutes back so you find your sit bones. Push your sit bones against the floor, extend the spine, open the chest, relax the shoulders. Keep your spine long, keep your neck long. Gently push the crown of your head up. Reconnect to your body. Reconnect to your breathing. Just take a few seconds to connect to the body. Open the arms, keeping the shoulders down. Extend the arms, extend the fingers, but don't tense the arms. Push the sit bones down. Feel the length of your spine. Feel the space between your vertebras. Push the crown of your head up. Inhale, extend. Exhale, put the left hand on the floor and gently extend the right arm out. Push the right sit bone against the floor. Gently push the right arm out. Allow the air to flow. Keep your shoulders away from the ears. Soften your face. And slowly inhale, come up, extend the spine, push the crown of your head up. Exhale, gently go to the other side. Push your sit bone down, extend the left arm up. Allow the air to flow. Feel the twist, feel the stretch on your left side of your body. Connect to your body, connect to this moment. Notice the air coming in, the air going out. Inhale, slowly come up, extend the spine. Exhale, go to the other side. One long exhalation. Extend as you exhale. Inhale, come up, extend. Push the crown of your head up. Exhale, go to the other side. One long exhalation. Extend as you exhale. Inhale, come up to the nose. Exhale, to the nose. Inhale, come up through the nose. Exhale, through the nose. Again, inhale up. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale, come up, extend, push the crown of your head up. Exhale, bring the left hand behind your body, right hand on the outside of your knee, extend the spine and gently twist, look toward the wall behind you, keep your shoulders down, away from your ears, allow the air to flow. Make your spine very long, soften your face, keep the air flowing, just connect to the twisting of your back, Push the crown of your head up, allow the air to flow. Inhale, come into the center, extend the spine. Exhale, turn to the other side. Keep your spine long. Left hand on the outside of your knee, pushing gently against your knee. The right hand is helping you to keep your spine long so you don't lean back. Allow the air to flow, soften your face. Inhale, come into the center, extend the spine. Exhale, change. One long exhalation to the nose, keep turning as you exhale. Inhale, center, extend. Exhale, turn. One long exhalation to the nose. Inhale, extend. Exhale, change. Inhale, extend. Exhale, change. One more time, inhale, extend, exhale, change, and inhale, extend, exhale, change. Inhale, open the arms, exhale, bring the palms together up, cross your fingers, extend the palms up. And extend your body. Extend. Sit bones are pushing against the floor. The palms are gently pushing up. Extend, extend the body. Inhale, extend a bit more. Exhale, bring the arms behind your body. Cross your fingers. Push the arms away from you. Arch the spine. Push the shoulder, the shoulders back. The shoulder blades close to each other. Bring the chin up and back and the sit bones pushing down. Arch the spine. Breathing. Inhale, arch a bit more if you can. Exhale, relax. Put the hands on your knees. Make some big circles with your shoulders. One way, and the other way around. Now, just shake a bit your hands. Just to warm up the wrist. Relax the forearms and just move the hands. One way, also with the palm facing up. And with the palm facing down. And again, move with your shoulders. Just very gently move a little bit your head. Just make a few circles with your head. Slowly, gently. One way and the other way around. And simply extend the legs in front, shake a little bit your legs, move a little bit your feet, one way and the other way, just move a bit your legs, and put the hands on the floor, turn around, and come into the all fours. Make sure the hands are right under the shoulders, and the knees are right under the hips. Push the floor with your hands, keeping the shoulders away from the ears. Now, don't collapse the shoulder blades. Push the floor with your hands, shoulders away from the ears. Push all the air out, round the spine. Inhale, arch the spine. Push the coccyx out, bring the head up and back. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch the spine, push the coccyx out, bring the head up and back. Exhale, round. And keep going at your own time. Keep going, paying attention to what you do. Paying attention to what you do. Notice the air coming in, the air going out. Pay attention to what you do. Deep inhalation when you arch, deep exhalation when you round. And notice the movement. This is very simple to do. Obviously, it's not a big effort to do it, but it's a wonderful movement for the spine. It's a wonderful movement also for the lungs. It expands the lungs. So take a deep inhalation when you arch and take a deep exhalation when you round. Just do it a few more times. Take your time, there is no hurry. And then just simply put your toes on the floor. Put your toes on the floor and try to sit back on your heels. If for any reason you cannot do this, don't worry, just you can stay on your knees, it's not a problem. But if you can, bend your toe, put your toes on the floor, sit back on your heels so you feel the stretch on your toes, shake a little bit your hands. Move a little bit your shoulders. One way and the other way. And then again, put the hands on the floor. Make sure the wrists are right under the shoulders and the knees under the hips, which means don't keep the hands and the knees too close to each other. Bring them apart. Now, extend the right leg back, push the floor with your hands. Don't bring the hip up, keep your hip down. Push the floor with your hands and extend the left arm in front. If for any reason you cannot extend the arm in front, keep it on the floor if it's too difficult, but try. Try to extend the arm in front. Don't push the shoulder away from you. Keep the shoulder back. Keep your neck long. Push the floor with your right hand. Now the arm is close to the ear. It's not down. It's close to the ear. And the right leg is as high as you can without bringing the hip up. Inhale. Exhale. Knee to forehead. Forehead to knee. And the left elbow come close to the left thigh. Don't collapse the shoulder blade. Keep pushing the floor with your right hand. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. And keep going slowly. Inhaling when you extend, exhaling when you round. Take your time. You don't have to go fast. Try to, as you do the movement, try to pay attention to your body and try to relax the body, even as you do the movement. You see, if you do a gym, you are worried about the gym, you are worried about how many times you do it, if you're really becoming stronger. But right now, don't do that. Connect to the body, and as you do the movement, do it with grace, do it with attention, do it with presence. This is not, we are not doing gym, we are doing presence. And then from presence, this movement is coming. Just a couple more times. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend, and stay there. Stay there breathing. Now put the left hand on the floor. Push the floor with both of your hands, shoulder away from the ears. Bring the left foot out to help you with the balance. Transfer the weight to the left hand. Open the trunk and bring the right arm up. Stay there for a few seconds. Breathing. I will turn around so I can see you. Breathe. Now, put the right foot flat on the floor, pushing the outside of your left foot outside, and bring the right arm close to the ear, open the trunk, push the shoulder back, and feel this intense stretch. At the same time, keep pushing the floor with your left hand. Keep pushing the floor with your left hand. Breathe. Feel the stretch. It's like the little finger of your right hand is extending out. Out, out. Now, slowly, again, bring the right leg up. Inhale and exhale. Bring the right elbow and the right knee close to each other. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale. Exhale, round. Inhale. Exhale, round. Inhale. Push the floor with your left hand. Exhale, round. Inhale. Exhale, round. Inhale. Exhale, round. Three more times. Inhale. Exhale, round. Inhale, exhale, round, and the last time. Inhale, exhale, round. Inhale, extend. And exhale, right hand on the floor, right knee on the floor. Push the floor with your hands. Put your toes on the floor. Come up. Sit back on your heels. Shake a little bit your hands. Just shake your hands. Move a little bit your shoulders one way and the other way around. And you can move a little bit your head, move a little bit your trunk. And we go down again the other way. So extend the left leg back. Make sure there is enough space between the hands and the knees. Inhale and exhale, extend the right arm in front. Stay there for a few seconds. Check your position. Try to bring the left leg as high as you can, keeping the hip down, and bring the arm as high as you can so the biceps is close to your ear. But don't push the shoulder out, keep the shoulder back. Inhale. Exhale, knee to forehead, forehead to knee. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round. And keep going at your own time. Make sure that you keep pushing the left hand against the floor, keeping the left shoulder away from the ear. Do it at your own time. Some of you may want to go a bit faster. Some of you may want to go a bit slower. There is not a one perfect speed. It's just connect to your body and do it according to what you need, how it feels good to you. But try to do it slightly slower. Just don't go too fast. So you have the possibility to check your body, to check the tensions, soften your face, soften your lips, make sure you're breathing. Deep inhalation when you exhale, when you extend, deep exhalation when you round. Just two more times. Round, inhale, extend, exhale, round, and inhale, extend. Stay there for a few seconds. Put the right hand on the floor. Bring the right foot back. Transfer the weight to the right hand. Open the chest and bring the left arm up. Push the floor with your right hand. The left leg remains up for now. Breathe. Push the floor with your right hand. Shoulder away from the ear. Don't bring the left shoulder close to the ear. Keep it away from me. Now, put the left foot flat on the floor. Push the outside of your left foot out and bring the left arm close to the left ear. Open the trunk and extend. Feel this intense stretch on the whole left side of your body. It's like the little
the little finger of your left hand is pushing out. If you want to touch the wall on the other side of, in front of you, and the outside of your foot wants to go down. Extend, extend, open the chest. Now, slowly, keep pushing the floor with your right hand, bring the left leg up. Inhale, exhale, knee to forehead, forehead to knee. Sorry, elbow to knee. Inhale, extend. Exhale, knee to elbow, elbow to knee. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. And keep going slowly. Inhale, extend. Exhale. Soften your face. If you get distracted with the gym, often the face gets tense. Pay attention. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Three more times. Exhale. Exhale. And the last one. Exhale. Inhale, extend. Exhale, put the left hand on the floor, left knee on the floor. Put your toes on the floor. Sit back on your heels. Come on up, shake a little bit your hands. From all directions. Move a little bit your shoulders. One way and the other way around. Open your chest, close your chest. Now, push your toes out. Sit back again on your heels. If you cannot, don't worry. Just come up onto your knees or put your glutes on the floor and sit normally on the floor. If you can stay on your knees, on your heels, put your palms on your thighs. And just for a few seconds, close your eyes. Stop for a moment. Stop for a moment. Connect to your body. Connect to your breathing. Hear the sounds around, but don't get lost on the sound. Just connect to this moment, just for a few seconds. Right, to really feel that you don't need to go to the next moment. The next moment is going to come to you. Don't go to the next moment. Allow the next moment to come to you. And just very slowly open the eyes, sit on the floor, and just simply lie on the floor. Keep your hands on your knees, move a bit gently right and left. Now open your arms with the palm facing down, keeping the shoulder blades on the floor. Bring the knees all the way towards your right side. Relax the right leg on the floor. Turn your head towards your left hand. Keep the left shoulder blade on the floor. This also is a very simple exercise, but I love this exercise. I feel this is such a healing movement for the spine, for the back. It feels such a healing movement to do. Slowly inhale, bring your knees up. And exhale, gently bring the knees all the way towards your left side. Keep the right shoulder blade on the floor. Turn your head, looking towards your right hand. And slowly inhaling your knees up. Exhale, go all the way to the right. Turn your head to the left, but barely touching the floor. Inhale, come up. Exhale, go all the way to the left, but barely touching the floor. Inhale. Exhale, go to the other side and keep going, right and left. Inhaling, coming up. Exhaling, going either right or left. Keep turning your head in the opposite direction from where you take your knees. You can close your eyes as you do this. Pay attention to your body, notice your breathing. Try not to get lost in your thought, and if you do get lost in your thought, and we all do, bring the attention back into the moment. Practice bringing the attention back into the moment. Just a couple more times. And slowly bring your knees to your chest. Push your knees slightly away from you. Keep your heels at the same level as your knees. Make sure that there is this inclination on your thighs. So the knees are not in front of your hips. They're not in front either, just slightly away from your hips. Bring the chest up, shoulder blades off the floor. Extend the arms in front, push the shoulders away from the ears, and very important, keep your chin away from the chest. Inhale, exhale, come up. Now stay there for a few seconds. Keep the shoulders down, don't push the shoulders out. Inhale, barely go down, the shoulder blades barely touch the floor. Exhale, come up. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. And keep going. When you exhale, push the air out to your mouth like if you're blowing through a very small straw. And keep going slowly. You inhale, barely touch the floor with your shoulder blades, and then you come up. It's a small movement, it's not a big movement. You don't have to come very high. Also, you don't have to go very low. Just barely touching the floor with the shoulder blades, and then you come up, pushing the air out, tightening the abdominals, pushing the navel in. And keep going slowly. Don't get too lost. Don't tense your face. Don't tense your lips. It's a gym. This is clearly a gym, but do it with presence. Every time you come up, push the air out. If you have any pain in your lower back, take a break. But if you can keep going, try to do a few more. Push the air out. Push the air out. See if you can do three more times. And relax down. You can keep your knees on your chest. You can put the sole of your feet together and open your knees, or you can extend the legs in front. Relax for a few seconds. Allow the air to flow. Take a few moments. Breathe. Reconnect your body. Reconnect your breathing. You can close your eyes. Relax your arms. Relax your legs. Make your abdominal very soft. Soften your face. Soften your mouth. Connect to the moment. Hear the sounds. Try to see this possibility to be in this moment. I think it's raining outside. And again, bring your knees to your chest. Put your arms beside your body with the palm facing down. Inhale, tighten the abdominals, and exhale, bring the knees towards your face, the glutes off the floor. Inhale, Exhale, inhale. Push the air out, pushing the glutes off the floor, the knees towards your face. Try not to use the impulse of your legs. If you need to, it's okay, but try not to use the impulse of your legs. Try to use 100% the strength of your abs to lift your glutes, to lift the whole lower body from the floor. That's the idea. Use the strength of your abs to try to lift your body. Don't tense your face. Try to make the effort to keep your face relaxed. As you do the gym, keep your lips relaxed, keep your eyes relaxed. Push the air out. Every time you make the effort, tighten the abdominals. It's not just to bring the glutes up, it's also to push the air out and tighten the abs. Keep going at your own time. If you have pain in your back, take a short break. Then you can continue, but don't do it with pain. Push the air out. Try to do it 3 more times. And relax down. Just take a very short break. Just keep the legs in any position that is comfortable for you. And then again, bring your knee to your chest, extend both of your legs up, and we will do a similar exercise than before, but a bit more intense. If this is too hard, come back to what you were doing before. Palm facing down, inhale. Exhale, imagine you want to bring the sole of your feet up towards the ceiling. Again, try not to use the impulse of your legs to come up, but try to use only the strength of your abs. You don't have to come very high. It's not about peeling the whole spine off the floor. Just a small movement. It's just like the glutes kick up, like if the glutes want to touch the ceiling. And keep going, pushing the air out, tighten the abs. Pushing the air out, tighten the abs. At your own time, if you have pain in your back, take a break. If you can keep going, try to do 5 more of these. Within your possibilities, it's not a competition. Within the possibilities. A few more. And at your own time, when you finish, relax down. Take a few moments. We will do one more up exercise working for the obliques, but not yet. Take a few seconds. Breathe. Now, put your feet on the floor. Bring the left foot on top of the right knee. Bring the right hand behind your head. Sorry, bring the left hand behind your head, and the right arm is crossed in front of your right knee. Inhale and exhale, like if you want to bring the right elbow to the left knee. And you look at your left elbow. Inhale, exhale. I want you to look at your left elbow. Inhale, exhale. Try to bring the left shoulder blade also off the floor. But look at your left elbow. And it's like if the right elbow wants to reach the left knee. So the left shoulder blade tries to come up, but at the same time, look at the left elbow. Try to do it 3 or 5 more times. And take a very short break. Bring the left foot down. Bring the right foot on top of the left knee. The right hand supports your head. Don't push on your head. Keep your chin away from the chest. And the left arm crosses in front of the right knee. Imagine you want to bring the left elbow to the right knee. You try to bring the right shoulder blade off the floor and you look at the right elbow. Inhale, exhale, exhale, exhale. This looking at the right elbow really helps you to turn, and it's a turning and at the same time to bring in the right shoulder blade off the floor what makes the oblique to work. Push the air out, tighten the abs. Try to do it 3 or 5 more times within your possibilities. Pushing the air out. And relax down, extend your legs. Bring the arms behind your head. Extend the arms, extend your legs. And take some time, really stretch your body. Feel the stretch on your whole of your body. Especially feel that the abs are getting stretched. Feel really the stretch of your abs. Extend, extend, extend. And then put your arms beside your body. Take a few seconds and relax down. Just breathe. Relax. You can close your eyes if you want to, but we'll continue. But take a few seconds. Relax your legs, relax your arms. Notice the air coming in, notice the air going out. Reconnect to the moment. Reconnect to your breathing. See how it feels, this possibility to stop. What does it feel? It's not a relaxation that makes you disappear like does a glass of wine or watching a movie. It's not that kind of relaxation. It's a relaxation that you are alert, you are present, but the body is relaxed. The mind feels this space that is always here, this great openness. Make a distinction between the relaxation of the glass of wine or the movie and the relaxation of presence. They are two different, completely different things. They may seem similar, but they are not.
Now bring your knees to your chest. Cross your feet, put your hands on your knees, and make some just up and down, massaging the whole of your back. All the way to your neck, all the way to your coccyx. And the next time, just simply come up, push the floor with your hands, bring the hands to the front of your mat, and either walk or jump back into a push-up position. Push the floor with your hands. Don't collapse the shoulder blades. Push the shoulders away from the ears. If you need to, you put your knees on the floor. If you can't, you keep the knees off the floor for a few more seconds, but neither collapse your hips, nor bring your hips too high. Try to keep like a table, one line of your whole body. Push the floor with your hands. Now we will do a few push-ups. Most of you put the knees on the floor. If you want to, you can keep your knees up. But try to keep the body in one line. Either from the knees to the shoulders or from the heels to the shoulders. One line, slowly going down. Inhale, come up.
Exhale, go down. And keep going, up and down.
If you need to put your knees on the floor, the shoulder to the knees, once, one whole block down, one whole block up. Even if you cannot go very low, it doesn't matter. You can just go 10 centimeters down and then 10 centimeters up. This already strengthens the whole body. Of course, if you can go deeper, you go deeper. Slowly down, slowly up. Don't collapse your body. One line from the knees to the shoulders, or if your knees are up, from the knees to the heels. One line. Now try to do a few more, but this time keep your elbows close to your body. Just try. It's a different muscle that works now. Keep your elbows close to your body. A few times up, a few times down. And the next time, just go all the way down and relax down. Relax down. Relax down. Now, extend the arms in front. Bring the forehead just barely above the floor. So what is important is that you keep your neck long. Don't look up. If you need to look at the screen, put your elbows up. Put your elbows down so you can come up, so you look up. But don't put pressure on your neck to look up. If you know the movement, you don't need to look at the screen, then just do from what you hear. Extend the arms in front. Inhale, tight abdominals, push the navel up. And exhale, bring the right leg and the left arm off the floor. Stay there for a moment. Breathe, breathe, but keep your abdominals tight. Don't look up, keep your neck long. Inhale, go down. Exhale, bring the left leg and the right arm up. Tie the abdominals. Allow the air to flow. Inhale, go down. Exhale, left arm and right leg. Inhale, go down. Exhale, right arm and left leg. Inhale, down. Exhale, change. Inhale, down. Exhale, change. Keep your leg long. Inhale, down. Exhale, change. Inhale, down. Exhale, change. Now, inhale, down. Exhale, bring both arms and legs and stay there. Both the arms and the legs are off the floor. Keep your neck long. Inhale. Exhale, relax down. Allow the air to flow. Breathe, relax down. You can put the cheek on the floor or you can put your forehead on your hands. Just take a few seconds, relax your tummy. Breathe. The next movement is a continuation of what we just did. We do the movement, it's called swimming. Most of you already know it. But please, just look at me for a second, just to see it once. So don't do it yet, just look at me. Inhale and exhale, you will bring the arms and the legs off the floor. The palms are going to face each other. And without looking up, keeping the neck long, you're going to move the arms and the legs like if you're swimming. The arms and the legs move quite fast, but what is important is that the abs are pushing in at all times and you're breathing as you move the arms and the legs. So all together, tight abdominals, extend the arms in front, inhale. Exhale, bring the arms and the legs off the floor. Stay there for a few seconds. The palms are facing each other. Inhale, tight the abdominals. Exhale, start to move. Arms and legs, like if you're swimming. Tight the abdominal, keep the abdominals pressed. And as you move, breathe. Keep breathing, keep breathing. It's quite fast, arms and legs, quite fast. Keep the abdominals tight. If you have pain in your back, please stop. You should not have pain in your back. We are working the muscles of the spine, but you should not have any pain on your back. If you do, please take a break. If you're quite tiring, try to keep going a few more seconds, 10 more seconds. Breathe, breathe. Quite fast, arms and legs, arms and legs. Last few seconds. Inhale, come as high as you can, extend, extend, extend. Exhale, relax down, bring the hands to the floor, push the floor with your hands. Come up onto your knees, sit back on your heels. Bring the forehead to the floor, bring the arms beside your body. And relax for a few seconds in the child's position. Relax down. Relax your arms, relax your shoulders, relax your face. Allow the air to flow. Breathe. It's raining quite strong outside. Breathe. If you hear the rain, enjoy the sound of the rain. Just relax into the sound. And now slowly extend the arms in front. Keep your neck relaxed. Keep the body exactly where it is. Just extend the arms in front. Walk with your hands away from you. Like if you want to reach the front of your mat. Spread your fingers, keeping the middle finger pointing right towards the front. Stay there for a few seconds. Feel the stretch on your arms, the stretch on your shoulders, on the upper back. Try to keep the glutes together with your heels. Stretch the arms in front. And slowly, pushing the floor with your hands. Inhale, come up onto your knees. Push the floor with your hands and very gently open into a cobra. Push the floor with your hands, shoulders away from the ears. Tie the abdominals, soften the face. Allow the air to flow. If this is too much for you, you can always put your elbows on the floor and push the floor with your elbows. So you don't collapse the shoulders. You push the floor with your elbows, keeping the shoulders away from the ears. If you can keep the hands, of course, keep the hands. Allow the air to flow. Stay there for a few more seconds, breathing. Tie the abdominals to protect the lower back. Now put your toes on the floor. Come up onto your knees. Sit back on your heels. Feel the stretch on your arms. Walk with your hands again away from you. Spread your fingers. Come up onto your knees. Push the floor with your feet. Bring your knees up. Push your chest towards your thighs. Keep your heels as high as you can. Push the floor with your hands, feel the stretch on your arms, feel the opening of your armpits, and now stretch the right leg, pushing the right heel towards the floor. Keep your left knee bent, push the floor with your hands, allow the air to flow. And bend the right knee, extend the left leg. Allow the air to flow. Remember, if your mat is slippery, This yoga mat should be non-slippery. This is a very good mat, but many mats are not so good. So if your mat's slippery, grab the side of your mat. Grab the side of your mat to help you from sleeping. If your mat is non-slippery, then keep the hands on the mat. Now, play a bit with your legs, extending the right and the left. And then, within the possibilities, extend both of your legs, pushing the heels toward the floor. Push the floor with your hands, soften your neck. Allow the air to flow. Feel the stretch on the whole back of your body. Keep pushing the floor with your hands. Imagine you want to get away from the floor, making your arms even a bit longer. Try to make the arms longer. Pushing the shoulders away from the ears. Extend the spine. If at any moment you feel it too much, you bend your knees, put your knees on the floor and take a short break. It's fine to take a break. If you can stay in the down dog, you stay in the down dog. Breathing, allowing the air to flow. Now push the left heel against the floor, extend the right leg out and up. Stay there for a few seconds. Imagine you want to bring the left heel towards the floor. And at the same time, try to bring the right leg as high as you can, but without lifting the hip. You keep the hip down, or square, not low, but square, and you bring the right leg as high as you can. Breathe, soften your neck, soften your face, push the floor with your hands, keep pushing the chest towards your thighs. Inhale. Exhale, bring your knee towards your face, pushing the knee up and bringing the weight towards your hands. Again, go back. Inhale, out and back. Exhale, knee towards your face. And the last time, inhale, out and back. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Now, because I have my problem here, I cannot bring my hip down, but try to bring your hip as low as you can. I can do it better than last week, but still, I cannot go all the way down. But for you, keep pushing the right knee forward and try to bring your hip as low as you can, stretching the body. And then very slowly, push the floor with your right foot and slowly come up. Try to go down. I cannot because I cannot stretch here. But if you can, go as low as you can. Keeping the hips square, open the chest, extend the spine. Keep your ribs in, extend the arms, palm facing each other. Allow the air to flow. Inhale, hands on the floor. Exhale, right foot back, push up position. Now, put your knees on the floor or not. Slowly going down. Push the floor with your hands, come into a cobra, open the chest. Put your toes on the floor and slowly come up into a down dog. Play a bit with your legs. And then extend your legs. Push the floor with your hands. Down dog. Soften your neck. Allow the air to flow. Now push the right heel against the floor. Extend the left leg out and up. Stay there for a few seconds. Breathing. Remember, it's not a competition. It's about connecting to your body as your body is, not imagining there should be something different from what it is. Connect to your body, respect your body, love your body. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face, weight on your hands. Again, inhale, out and back. Exhale, knee towards your face. Last time, inhale, out and back. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale, exhale, foot between your hands.
Feel the stretch.
Try to bring the hip low, pushing the left knee forward. And then pushing the floor with your left foot. Slowly come up. Arms up, shoulders down. Breathe. Allow the air to flow. Keep your ribs in, extend the spine, soften the shoulders, extend the arms. Inhale, hands on the floor.
Exhale, left foot back.
Knees on the floor or not, slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. Toes on the floor, come up into a down dog. We do one more time to flow. Left heel against the floor, right leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Inhale, come up. Slowly. Exhale, hands on the floor, right foot back. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. Exhale, come up into a down dog. Take a couple of deep breaths, allow the air to flow. Right heel against the floor, left leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hands on the floor, left foot back, slowly going down. Inhale, come up, down dog. Allow the air to flow. We do it one more time, same thing. Another flowing sun salutation. Left heel against the floor, right leg out and out. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Inhale, come up. Try to flow in presence. Exhale, hands on the floor, right foot back. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up. Exhaling, down dog. Try to make the movement as if it was a meditation in action, a meditation in movement. Take your time, do it in peace, do it in presence. Right heel against the floor, left leg out and up. Inhale, exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale, exhale, foot between your hands. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hands on the floor, left foot back, slowly going down. Inhale, come up, down dog. Stay there for a few seconds. If it's too much, you can take a break. You can put the knees on the floor, relax your body. If you want to stay in down dog, stay there breathing. We'll start to do some variations on the movement. Take your time. If you need to take a break, take a break. If you can stay in down dog, keep pushing the floor with your hands. Keep extending your body. Allow the air to flow. If you're not in down dog, we continue. Go back to down dog. Left heel against the floor, right leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale, exhale, foot between your hands. Now bring the left foot flat on the floor, keeping the right heel and the left heel more or less in the same place. Inhale, come up. Exhale, turn, warrior two. I cannot open here very much, but please try to go as low as you can within the possibilities. Keep the right knee open.
and breathe. Now, from here, turn towards the right. Keep pushing the right knee forward. Bring the arms behind your body, cross your fingers, extend the arms out, away from you, and gently pushing the right knee forward. Try to arch the spine, pushing the arms away from you. Keep pushing the right knee as far as you can. I'm not going very far because I cannot stretch here. But if you can, try to go deeper within the possibilities. Maybe you're like me and you cannot go further than this. That's okay. Just do what you can do within your possibilities. Inhale and exhale, keeping the arms away from you. Try to bring the right shoulder on top of the right knee. Slowly. The right shoulder on top of the right knee. Most of the weight is on your right foot. The arms are away from you, and the shoulder is resting on your right knee. It's quite a bit of strength for the right leg. Stay there breathing. Stay there breathing. Now, some of you, this is already enough. You cannot go any deeper, so stay there. But if you can, you will bring the right shoulder outside of the right knee and try to go deeper, like if you want to bring the chest towards the floor. Of course, you will not reach the floor, but it's like if you want to bring the chest closer to the floor. The arms are still away from you. It's quite intense on the right leg. Stay there breathing, breathing. Soften your face, soften your lips. Just a few more seconds. If it's too much, bring the shoulder back on top of your knee. Breathe, breathe. Inhale. Exhale. Let go of your hands. Bring both of your hands on the inside of your right foot. Now, bring the left heel up. This is very important. Bring the left heel up. Now, very gently, try to bring your left, put your left knee on the floor. Now, bring the left elbow to the floor if you can. If you cannot, just keep both hands up. If you can, try to bring the left elbow to the floor, and then within the possibilities, and keeping your right knee on top of your right foot, try to bring the right elbow also to the floor. For some of you, this is too much, so keep the right hand on the floor, even both hands on the floor. But if you can, you bring the left elbow, and then you bring the right elbow down. And if you can, try to bring the left knee also off the floor. And stay there breathing. Stay there breathing. The left knee can be off the floor, or if it's too much, keep it on the floor. You can keep both elbows on the floor, on the inside of your right foot. Or if it's too much, you keep the right hand on the floor, or you keep both hands on the floor. It's a very intense stretch. Try to keep a big distance between, if your knee's on the floor, keep a big distance between the right foot and the left knee. Stay there for a few more seconds. Now, put the left knee on the floor. Bring the right hand to the floor, bring the left hand to the floor. One more time, bring the left knee off the floor. Transfer the weight to the left hand, open the trunk, and extend the right arm up. Breathe. Open as much as you can. All the weight is in your left hand and your right foot. And slowly, inhale, bring the right hand to the floor, exhale, right foot back, push up position. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. And slowly, come up into a down dog. Allow the air to flow. Now push the right heel against the floor, against left leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Bring the right foot flat on the floor. Inhale, come up, palms together, facing forward. Push the left knee forward. And turn into a warrior two.
Look to the middle finger of your left hand. Open the trunk.
Inhale. Exhale, turn. Face forward again. Bring the arms behind your body. Cross your fingers. Extend the arms away from you and gently arch the spine. But at the same time, keep pushing the left knee forward. So go as low as you can, pushing the left knee, and extend the arms out, arching the spine. Breathe. Inhale. And exhale, keeping the arms away from you. Try to bring your left shoulder on top of the left knee.
Slowly. Keep the arms as far as you can away from your body. Breathing.
Stay there breathing. Try to bring the left shoulder as much as you can on top of your left knee. Keep your chest open. Open there. Open the chest out. Allow the air to flow. Allow the air to flow. Now, you can stay there, and that's wonderful. But if you can go deeper, try to bring the left shoulder on the inside of your left knee, like if you want to bring your chest closer to the floor. That's quite intense because there is a lot of strength resting on the left leg. Stay there for a few seconds, just for a few seconds, breathing.
Inhale, exhale, let go of your hands, bring both of your hands to the inside of your left foot. Bring the right heel up. Push the floor with your hands. Now put the right knee on the floor. But make sure there is quite a bit of distance between the left heel and the right knee. Now within the possibilities, and maybe it's not for everybody, try to put the right elbow on the floor. See how far you can go. And then you try to bring the left elbow also to the floor. Keep your left knee as much as you can on top of your left foot. Now, you can keep the right knee on the floor, or you can try to bring the right knee up. This makes it just more intense, so it's not necessary. But if it's good for you, bring your knee up. If you need to, keep your knee up, keep your knee down. Also, you can put the left hand on the floor, if it's too much, or come up and put both hands on the floor. Even like this, with the hands on the floor and the knee on the floor, still quite a bit of stretch. If you can go deeper, right elbow, left elbow, right knee up. Breathe, connect to the body. And slowly bring the right knee to the floor. Left hand on the floor, right hand on the floor. One more time, bring the right knee up. Transfer the weight to the right hand, open the trunk, extend the left arm up. Inhale, exhale, hand on the floor, left foot back. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. And come up into a down dog. We do one more variation. Take a few seconds, breathe, soften your face. Push your left heel against the floor, right leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Left foot flat on the floor. Inhale, come up. Exhale, turn, warrior two. Look to the middle finger of your right hand. Inhale, extend the right leg. Push the hip in. Extend out, out, out. Inhale. Exhale, triangle position. Imagine you want to bring your ribs towards your thighs. So don't push so much with your hand down, push more with your ribs towards your thighs. Allow the air to flow. Connect to the body, connect to your breathing.
Don't just do gym, do present. Now inhale. Exhale, turn towards your right, open like an airplane. Imagine you want to bring the navel towards your right thigh, extending the spine. Now bend the right knee, bring the left heel up and stepping, pushing in front, come up into an airplane. You can start with a right knee bend. If you can extend the knee, you extend the knee, but if you need to, keep your right knee bent. Keep your neck long. Bring the left leg as high as you can. Breathe. Now, from here, slowly start to come up. Don't put the foot on the floor. Bring your knee up. Look in front. Extend the spine. Push the right foot against the floor. Push the crown of your head up. Extend the spine. Inhale. Exhale, try to extend the right leg in front, pushing the heel out. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Stay there, breathing. Inhale, bend, and slowly start to go back again. Airplane position, slowly, slowly, slowly. Now, from here, try to bring the left foot all the way to the back of your mat. Inhale, come up. Exhale, hands on the floor. Right foot back. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. And come up into a down dog. Allow the air to flow. We do the other side and then we finish the class. Push your right heel against the floor, extend the left leg out and up. Inhale. Exhale, knee towards your face. Inhale. Exhale, foot between your hands. Right foot flat on the floor. Inhale, come up. Exhale, turn warrior two. Very gently, inhale, extend the left leg. Push the hip in, extend out. I cannot stand out. Push the hip in, extend. Imagine you want to bring the ribs toward the wall. Extend out, inhale. Exhale, triangle position. Stay there for a few seconds, breathing. Extend, push the ribs towards your thighs. Don't bring the hands so low, push the ribs down. You want to extend, you want to push from the hips. Allow the air to flow. Deep and fluid breathings. Now, from here, turn to your left. Imagine you want to bring the navel to your left thigh. Bend the left knee and then bring the right heel up. Step onto your left foot and open into an airplane. You can start with your left knee bent. Start with your left knee bent. Keep the hip down. If you can, you will extend the leg. But if you cannot, keep your left knee bent and try to extend the body. Breathing. Just do the best you can. Don't worry for it. Just do the best you can within the possibilities. Allow the air to flow. And then, very slowly, start to bring your left right knee up. Slowly bring your right knee up. Look in front. Push the floor with your left foot. Extend the spine. Don't push the hip in front. Keep your hip back. Inhale. Exhale, extend the right leg in front. Push the heel up. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Try to extend, tighten the abdominals, pushing the heel out. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. And the last one. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Stay there for a few seconds, pushing the heel out. And then bend the knee again. Slowly go back into the airplane position. Inhale. Exhale, bring the right foot all the way to the back of your mat. Arm up. And exhale, hands on the floor. Left foot back, push-up position. Slowly going down. Inhale, come up into a cobra. And come up into a down dog. Stay there for a few seconds. Soften your neck, soften your face. Push the floor with your hands. Push the heels towards the floor. And then bend a bit your knees, look between your hands, and either walk or jump between your hands. Stay there. And we're going to just sit on the floor. I'm going to finish the class with a final relaxation. But before you relax, let's take a few seconds just to move the body. Stretch the body. You can extend your legs, open the legs. You can twist your spine. If you feel like it, you can bring your legs behind your head. Just for the next few seconds, just do any movement that you feel that your body needs to do in order to relax in a more comfortable way. So just move for a few more seconds. Just move for a few more seconds. And then, very slowly, start to find a comfortable position. Extend your legs, the arms beside your body with the palm facing up. If you have a pillow, put your pillow under your head to be more comfortable. Close your eyes. Allow the weight of your body to rest on the floor. You did your class. You made the effort to be here, which was a big effort for you. It was an effort to be here today. You made the effort. Now it's fine to stop. Now it's fine to relax. Allow the weight of your body to rest on the floor. Just take a few seconds. Stay here with me. Stay here in this time. It's very important to assimilate the class by allowing, even if it's only a few seconds, to relax the body. Let go of your legs. Allow the weight of your legs to rest on the floor. Let go of your arms, your hands, and your fingers. Try to see that to relax, you don't have to relax, you just have to let go. And let go just means allowing the moment to be as it is. Relax just means stop fighting with what you find. Stop resisting what you find. Allow the moment to be as it is. Make your abdominals very soft, allowing the air to come in and the air to go out. Allow your chest to open.
Soften your shoulders. Soften your neck. Soften your face, your lips, your eyes, your forehead. Feel the weight of your head resting on the floor. And just for a few seconds, feel the sensation of the whole body resting on the floor. There is nowhere to go. There is nothing to do. There is not even anything to relax. It's just allowing the moment to be as it is. But try to see why. Relaxation is not something that one can do. One hopes that I hope to relax, but then maybe the body will relax or maybe not. Maybe the mind will relax, maybe not. There is not much we can do about that. But allowing the moment to be as it is, that is something we can do because it's an attitude. It's only an attitude inside. We don't have control over the relaxation, but you have control if you're aware of your attitudes. Allow this moment to be as it is. Just for a few seconds, stay in silence. I will stay with you just for a few seconds in silence. There's nowhere to go. There is nothing to do. Just being here, letting go. Of course, if you can stay and if you want to stay, stay as long as you want in this position. Just relaxing, just letting go. But if you're ready to come up, you can allow more air to come in, allow more air to go out. Start to stretch your arms, stretch your legs, stretch your body. And at your own time, when you're ready, there is no hurry. When you're ready to come up. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure to be here with you. Thank you for being here. We have on Wednesday morning, we will have a meditation, and on Wednesday evening, if you're interested, I would like to have a session of questions and answers about my book. And I wish you a very nice week. And all the best. Thank you very much. If you like the class, you can give it a like, leave some comments in the live chat, the usual. Thank you very much. I wish you a very nice evening. Ciao.